Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to Body Challenge. So today is going to be a little bit different. Instead of actually just doing a full workout, we're going to do a workout game. Now I'm going to teach you and show you some ideas on how to make your own game at home. So you can use this anytime, anywhere, anytime you're homeschooling or you need a break. So I really believe that we learn better if we feel good. So we have to take care of our body. So then that way we can learn better and work and focus. I have always done something within our classroom, which I'm in today, which is really fun. It's empty, so I miss all my students, but they said could come. And I also did it when I was homeschooling. I homeschooled all five of my kids through elementary, and I loved it. But we always did something I call active breaks. Or at school, sometimes we call them brain breaks, right? So when you're working and you're doing your schoolwork and sometimes you just get bogged down and then because you've been sitting a while. So I like our active breaks / brain breaks. So you get to choose how you're going to set this up. And I like to make it fun and make it a game. So I'm going to show you a few ideas. I've got some different things that I'll share with you. So when we do our little workout, there's a lot of ways you can do it. You can do it by time. So say every time we do an active break, we're going to take 5 minutes. Or maybe you want to say, we're going to do this much of this kind of exercise. So you can set it by time or repetitions or however you choose to design it. So I'm going to show you some ideas and then I'm going to demonstrate a workout one. So one that I have in my classroom that I've used in body challenge classes before and just like in the middle of history or science, if the kids are getting a little bit wiggly, we get up, we do an active break, and then we jump back onto our project. So, Easter eggs. Hey, we just had Easter. I bet you have some of these around. These are so fun. These are little animal-based ones. And inside, you just pop open the egg. And I have a little piece of paper. And it has a little exercise written on it. So this one says, bear walk around the room. Or you could put around your house. So you do a lap. Doing a bear walk, which means hands and feet, bums up, no knees, right? So you're down in this position and you have to crawl around the room or around your house for a minute. So lots of fun. So that gets you moving. And then as soon as you're done with your active break, you put it back in the jar or you can set it to the side if you plan on going through all your activities during the day, not necessarily all at one sitting, but during the day. So that's one fun way I like to encourage my students and my own children to be active. Here's some front kicks. So you get to be creative and design your own kind of exercises that you enjoy doing. And just make it fun and creative, just in a little basket right here. Another idea that I've used in my classroom and at home is popsicle sticks. They can be used for so many things. I have some colored ones here. I've used them in class for choosing sticks, but I've also written exercises on them. You can just get any kind of cup or jar or container. Here's some of the wide, like tongue depressor, the wide craft sticks. You can find these in colored or the natural. And so on each one of these, you would then write another exercise on or an activity. So say you wanted to go jump on the trap for 5 minutes, right? So you get a 5 minute trampoline break. Or if you really love basketball, ooh, let's go play 10 minutes of basketball with mom or with your brothers or little sister or whoever is around. So you get to go do an activity to get moving. And then right after that activity, you go right back to your work, your schoolwork. But in this case, we're just going to focus on the activity part. You can incorporate these into your homeschool routine, however you choose. But we're just thinking about the workout. So to make a workout fun and have lots of variety, you would write down, maybe you get 15 or 20 sticks, write down the exercises, and you can save these, of course, and reuse them whenever you wanted. So say you had 50 popsicle sticks and you wrote down 50 exercises. So say, we're gonna do a workout, let's choose 10, put them in a cup, and then you take turns with your family or a friend choosing the sticks and decide what goes next. I definitely recommend some fun music because music helps me get motivated and have fun. So I have an assistant who is unseen today, my daughter. She's going to be running the music. And so I'm just saying, music on, and we'll do our exercise. So I'm going to just show you really quick. I just like to use the index cards. And I'm going to just cut these in half. Actually, I'll just fold them. I'll just keep them big. And I'm going to write some exercises on them. Today, we're only going to do 8. So that way, when you're watching this video, you can follow along with me. Or when we're done with this, you sit down and make your own. You can do 8, 10, 15, 20, as many as you can think of. Little exercises that then we're going to put into a little jar, choose them out, and I'm going to demonstrate just a few, and then we'll be done. And then you get to go and create your own fun workout. And the great thing is, it's mobile, right? You go on a trip, you got a workout with you. If you go camping, you can do an extra bonus workout. If you're just sitting in your living room going, woe is me. Or if it's a rainy day, hey, let's do a fun workout, right? So you will have your workout game with you whenever, anytime you want to do it. So will you throw me a marker? I forgot to grab a marker. Got it. Okay, so I'm going to write down some exercises. I'm going to do a 1-minute jumping jack because jumping jacks are awesome. They're one of the number one exercises for getting cardio, heart rate up. Let's see. I'm going to then do. I know a lot of people complain about burpees, but burpees are awesome. We're going to just do 10 burpees. Okay, so you can write these down on your own papers now or later. Okay, my third exercise I'm going to do is I'm going to do some chair step-ups. Now, a chair step-up can be done on any kind of chair you've got around, anywhere. Even if it's just a fireplace or maybe you have a little crate like I've got in my classroom here, these milk crates, you could just step up and down on a crate if you're really light. So I'm going to do some chair step-ups. And I'm going to do 30 seconds on each leg, and I'll demonstrate that. So I'm just going to write chair step up. Okay, so there's 3. Number 4. Let's do some front kicks. Okay. Number 5. I'm going to get an idea from here. What's one of my eggs say? That one said push-up. Push-ups are always good. I'm going to put 20 push-ups, but you can write down whatever number that you want to put down. You can even say do push-ups for 30 seconds or do push-ups for a minute and kind of time yourself and see how many you can get done as long as you're doing them right. I'm just going to go for doing 20. Okay. There's 5. Got 3 more. Let's see what's another fun, popular one the kids like to do. They like to do a lot of frog jumps. Let's definitely do frog jumps. Okay, 2 more to go. Emmy, what's another one? What's one you like? Cartwheels? Oh, I don't think I can demonstrate a cartwheel in here. Let's see. Oh, high knees. We'll do high knees. And I'm going to set a time limit on that. We're just going to do 30 seconds of high knees. Okay, my last card. Hey, let's see. I'm going to choose one from my eggs to help me. Simple basic jump squat. We're going to do 30 jump squats. Okay, so now that I've got these cards, remember when you're done, you save the cards. You can put them in a little Ziploc baggie and label them and maybe make 2 or 3 different sets that you randomly will use at different times. Or maybe you have a popsicle set. And then a card set. Okay, So I'm gonna mix these up. And I'm just gonna throw them in my little basket that has the eggs in it too. But I'm gonna just randomly choose one. I will have my music assistant turn the music on and we'll do the exercise. Go from there. Okay, we are ready. Music on. We're starting with push-ups. Okay, go. All right, a little bit louder. Okay, we're gonna get down on the ground. We're gonna do our 20 push-ups. Here we go.
One more time.
Or somewhere, I actually have a timer on my watch. So I'm gonna use that. I'm gonna set my timer. Ooh, I have to scroll for a second. For 1 minute for our front kicks. Ready, music on? And begin! Okay, point to kick it. You got it! Kick from the power from your heel. Okay, it might be a little bit lower. Bring it a little bit higher. Get up the knee. Kick it hip high. Or if you can really reach, the power from your heel. Really mean it when you kick it. Like you're kicking a door or a wall. Don't really do that. Air kick. Good job. Keep kicking.
We don't stop.
I like to use my arms for balance. You can kind of move them back and forth. Maybe punch the opposite arm. Getting close. 10 seconds.
Come on. One more time. One more time. A celebration. You know.
Oh, there's my watch. Buzzing. Okay, close. Music. All right, that was our 1 minute. Let's see what our next one is. 10 burpees. Okay, so full burpee. I'm gonna demonstrate one, then I'm gonna have to do 9 more. So you go down, touch the ground, jump out to a plank, which means you put your legs back, keep your body straight, jump back in. So you're kind of like in a frog stance, and jump straight up. Power from your legs. Okay, so that's one burpee. So I got 9 more to go. Music back on. Here we go. Down, out, in, and up. Chair step up. Okay, so I'm gonna grab a chair. I got my classroom chair. say. So you have a right chair, step up, lead, and a left chair, because right and left leg. So I'm going to start with my right. So I'm going to put my foot firmly, whole foot on the chair. We don't want anybody falling off. So up, touch, down. So I'm going to do a right lead for 30 seconds. And then on the next 30 seconds, left lead. So left goes up first, touch, down, down. Okay, so I'm going to set it for 30 and then restart it for the other leg. Okay, music on. Here we go. Right up and touch. Right up. And up. And up. Good job, keep going.
Okay, good enough.
already went. I did 20. All right. So our last one is 1 minute jumping jack. Okay, so really simple. I just have to go over the basics with my beginner students. If you already know jumping jack, don't worry. You start with the feet together, hands down. Jump it out, hands and feet. Jump it in. That's one jumping jack. Okay, so we're gonna do 1 minute. Let me set my timer. Okay, 1 minute. Go ahead, music. Ready, go. Cards, or if you do use the cute Easter eggs and colors, once in a while put the papers in a different egg so that you don't memorize what color and what the workout is. Or, oh, let's avoid that one, and so it stays more random and fun. Okay, so have fun creating your do your own workout game. Challenge your mom, challenge your dad. When we're done with quarantine, challenge your grandma, an aunt, an uncle, a cousin. Get together with friends. But you can definitely incorporate this at any time into your homeschool work. So say you did your spelling, good job, go pick an active break. Or you finished your writing, you made your story look so good and you did the details, your capitalization, you did your punctuation, woohoo, pick a card, right? Do an active break, keep that blood pumping and stay excited, get your schoolwork done and then do some other fun things, okay? I love you guys. Keep working, keep exercising, take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next time, okay?